Have you ever tried crab snaring on the pier? A crab snare is a wire device with a lead weight and 6 loops. Crab nets don't work as well because of the sea lines. You're allowed to use 2 fishing poles and 2 crab snares on the pier. December, the crabs were really nice. I check mines every 5 minutes and hopefully I get one of these guys. We had a great trip over here in Pacifica Pier. Big crabs out there. Some days are different. Today I'm going to talk to you about my fishing pier setup. I use this old grocery cart to bring all my stuff and it helps a lot. I added the 3 rod holder in the back to hold my rods. Believe it or not, it holds everything. The best thing to do is figure out what you need on the pier and set it up at home and make sure it fits before you leave the house. That way you don't forget nothing. Most of the time I just leave all the stuff in this cart and never touch it when I'm done. Well, that's it for the slideshow. Let's get back to this video. Today I'm going to show you an easy way to get on the pier and bring all your stuff. I'm going to show you today how to put all your stuff together in a cart. What I have here is my choice of rods. This is good if you're going to be fishing in winter season. You don't know if it's going to rain or you want to cover your fishing gear. Okay, just open it up and cover it. This right here are gloves, and I'll show you how I put on the rope to the bucket to get water for the crabs. Okay, I got the straps and bungee cords, wash bucket, bucket for salt water, and bucket for keep the crabs in. And this cooler is full of food and drinks. Okay. And if you go to a flea market, you can get this for like at least $15 to $20. This right here is my 50-foot rope, and I use this to connect to the bucket so I could get some water. And I usually just clip it on like that, and then I lower it down to the pier. The pier is about like 25 feet high, or maybe a little less, something like that. But this is enough rope to hold it. These are my gloves to pull the bucket. See the sinker right here? As soon as the bucket hits the water, the sinker will submerge the bucket down into the ocean. That way it'll cause it to dip and get water, and then you can bring it back up and pull it. So it's good that you put a little sinker at the end of your rope that's connected to your bucket. After you're done, just take it off, put this away, and you can fill this up with fresh water to wash your hands from the squid or fish, whatever you want to do. This is for my bait. I put all my frozen bait and whatever I need to put in there, drinks, sandwiches, but mostly this is for bait. Okay, sometimes you'll need a knife, cut your bait up, and this is to cover your gear from the rain or yourself. I got this at Kmart for $3. Sometimes it gets kind of, sometimes you want to sit down and you don't want to sit on the bench because it's full of fish stuff and bird stuff. So this is kind of good to have. It's kind of lightweight, only $3. This is where all my gear is at, or extra fishing line and stuff. This nail cutter, just in case you want to cut your line. And this right here is a crab snare key. And I use this to hook the key and open up the snare so I don't have to use pliers, none. Made it out of coat hanger. Rubber glove that I cut, and I use it for throwing my fishing line. And during the winter time, your fingers get really cold, so I made one of these. I cut one of these to protect my finger. Now, the thing I used different is I cut a hole here and I put a rubber band. So there's 2 rubber bands, and what you're gonna do is this. See? Now it won't come off. It's good. So this is good to use. Okay, so when you don't need it, just take it off, let it hang like that. That way your fingers are dry. Okay. So this is kind of a good thing to have. Okay, now let me show you how I put all my stuff together. Okay, so what I'm going to do is these buckets, I want to use these. So I put that in there. My rope. My gloves. My knife. Sharp knife facing down. You don't want to reach in there and get stuck with it.
Okay. So I got my lid right here. Get this out of the way. So what I do is I put my lid right there, my bucket, then I get my bag. Put it right there. And the seat slips into here. Okay, this piece of wood right here is like a chopping board for my bait and when I put my snares and stuff so they don't slide around, my sinkers don't pop off. So I put that on top of there and I also use it for my cooler. So this goes up like that. And then here's my bait. Here's my bait cooler. Just strap it on the top like that. See this? So the weight's gonna hold that. And then I get this. Now, this is optional. You don't need to bring this, but if you decide to bring some food and drinks, you got them covered, okay? So this is when the bungees come in. I only need two, but I bring extra just in case. So I hook it up like this. And go to the back. That way you don't have any accidents. Okay. So we're almost done. Now let's go to the back here. So we get the fishing poles. And then I get the straps. Okay, now, just in case you want to use the extra bungees, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put it here. Okay. That's just if I need it. All right, guys. I'll see you guys at the pier.